Hey, hello, welcome to Lead Code Contest 203. And in this video, I'll be showing how I solved this find latest group of size M problem. We have shared you an approach to solve this problem using prefix and suffix sum, but I didn't use that approach. CPEdit number 2 used that approach, and in this video, I'll be showing you how I solved this problem. I actually used disjoint sets for this problem. So to begin with, let's first see what a disjoint set is. So a disjoint set basically provides us two functionalities. So those two functionalities are, if we are given two groups, like this is a group 1 and another group 2, we can merge them into a group, a single group. So it will, the elements of the one group and two group will together form a new group. And the other functionality the disjoint sets provide is, we can check if two elements are given, or let's say if a single element is given, we can check which group that element belongs to. So coming back to the problem, in this problem it is clearly said that at each step we'll be marking the index at array I as 1. So in the first step we'll be marking third as 1, and in the second step we'll be marking fifth element as 1. So as you can notice, at each step we'll be creating a new group. So if there is no one on right or left, it is just same as creating a new group. And the other thing that you may notice is, if there is a one on its right, it should create a single group after placing a one. For example, in this 0, if we had placed 1, it would create a single group. This will be a single group of size 2. And likewise, if we had to place a 1 here, it will create a single group of size 3. So if we are checking if we are placing a 1, we could possibly end up merging 3 groups. Like the group on the right, it could have been 3 threes. So like in this example, this is a one group, this is the second group, and if we place a 1 here, we'll be merging all these 3 groups. So what that means is, this is a single group. It is same as saying that we place a 1 here, that is, we create a group here, and then we merge this group with this group, the left group. And after a single group is formed, we check if there is a 1 here, then we can merge both these groups. So we will maintain all the groups, that is all the sizes that are existing in our array of the groups. This is the same thing I did here. What I did was, I created, whenever I am placing a 1, I place a 1, I set the size of the current group as 1. It is same as creating a new group. And after that, I'm saying that we have another group of size 1. And after that, I'm checking if there is a 1 on its left, then I'm merging those two groups. And if there is a 1 on its right, then I'm merging both the groups on the right. So if you can notice, if there is a value of m in this set contains all the values, I mean the all the sizes of the groups that exist till this point. So if there is a group of size m at this point, I'll set answer as i plus 1. So I is 0 index, so I'm adding 1 to it, and then I return answer. So I have initialized answer with minus 1, so that if we do not find any answer, so we'll be returning minus 1. So that's all for this solution, and the implementation of DSU is pretty standard. I'm using path compression and I'm not using the other heuristic, just for the sake of ease, and it is, and for any practical implementation you can consider DSU as almost linear. It is very, very fast. You can consider it as almost linear. So this problem gave me an AC, so we can try submit it, and I'll show you that it is actually a correct solution. So that's all for this video. Hope you liked this one, and see you in the next one. Please like and subscribe our channel. No, like our video and subscribe our channel. These are two different things you need to do.